gray sky, hello blue. There's nothing can hold me when I hold you. It feels so right, it can't be wrong. Rocking and rolling all week long. Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday, happy days. Saturday, what a day.
Author Winston Alouicious Fonzerelli, known to his friends as Fonzie, was born in Milwaukee in 1938. His father, a sailor, left home before Arthur was born and hardly ever returned to America, preferring the bright lights and exotic nightlife of the Bangkok ladyboy scene. His father left him one thing, a locked box containing a signed photo of Al Johnson, and he gave him only one piece of advice. Don't go out if it's raining, it'll mess up your hair. Arthur's mother led a secretive life, hardly having anything to do with him. She spent most of her time traveling the country as a pest controller. The main influence in Arthur's upbringing was his grandmother. She was a renowned speedway rider with many trophies under her belt. She rose to fame as the only speedway rider in heels and a bonnet. By the time he was 5, Arthur was a member of a local biker gang and dropped out of school for a life on the road. By the time he was 7, he was a mechanic and a womanizer, harnessing the power of leather and hair grease to become the role model for a generation of post-war teenagers. Aged 8, Fonzie tired of the road and settled in the attic of a family called the Cunninghams. They eventually discovered him when their son Richie befriended him one evening and coaxed him out of the attic like a shy badger with a bottle of cheap cider. The Cunninghams allowed Arthur to stay in the attic, even helping him to recuperate after he suffered horrific injuries during a brutal and prolonged gang rape by a rival biker gang. The police report stated that Arthur lost so much blood during the ordeal, he was kept alive purely by his cool. From that day forward, he never rode a Harley Davidson. He preferred a cheap Honda. Arthur was a natural inventor, an entrepreneur, bringing many worthwhile items to the market. This income allowed him to hang around with Richie and his high school pals every day. He was also credited with inventing the Fonzie scheme, a semi-illegal trading racket. He became a father figure to the local kids. He had strict morals and often punished those who bullied the innocent. This morality once got him in trouble with Batman. Arthur became notorious for his ability to steal from vending machines and jukeboxes using a technique known as the Fonzerelli toe tap. At one point, he was stealing so much from Arnold's diner that the owner, a large Italian man, had a complete nervous breakdown and turned into a small Asian man. Arnold's friends pretended not to notice. Arthur briefly served in the military. Although his actions are a top secret, all that is known is that he once captured an enemy machine gun nest using only his thumbs. One memorable time in Arthur's life was when he became the target of an alien abduction. Although this was never reported in the media, there are many witnesses, and skeptics believe this is another cover-up of the proof of alien life, whereas some say the abduction was the result of some really bad acid. Arthur's demise came as the result of a daredevil stunt gone wrong. His highly publicized attempt to jump 13 garbage cans left him so smashed up he was unable to raise a thumb or say A. After extensive rebuilding and plastic surgery, he has adapted to his new look and is currently thriving.